Guys, welcome to Craft Create Paint. Today we're going to be making a big bongo drum for my carnival party. So you will need some different colour spray paints, an empty container. We've used a mango chutney drum, barrel. I'm so excited about this one because this is another one of my spray paint ones and I haven't used spray paint for ages. Well, now I think I'm going to use this to cover my nose. Spray about 10 centimetres away. That rhymes. So we have now done covered the labels. You're not going to want a label showing at a party, do you? And by the way, we'll already get covered because of our spray paint. Now I think I'm going to go do my next colour. But we're still going to keep the blue, just make it all colourful. Just some drops in the... See, that looks cool. Onto my light purple. We built this lid with our spray paints just in case we ever wanted to do specks on top of some colours. This one's got a long nozzle and you can get it from special spray paint shops. It's about 1 centimetre long. It's about 3 centimetres long. It's about 2 centimetres long. Now we're going over the drum with all different colour speckles so we can keep our nice blue colour. Hold it about 30 centimetres away. Press lightly. So this is what turns out, nice speckles. Now we're going to use speckles again with turquoise. Every colour I use I'm going to just walk around and spray. Now I'm going to do some specks again with this greenish colour. Can you see this lovely piece of art? And I want to be an artist when I grow up, so this is all really good. And this is probably my favourite YouTube video yet. I don't care if this video is long, because this is a masterpiece! So first we're going to do a little test. This is what it comes out like. And then, whoops! Gold. My last two colours are gold and silver. Ta-da! The spray painting is finished. So this is where we left you at last time. So now we're going to be adding some bells and some beads on. Here's my thread that I'm going to use. And now, it's for you to tie a knot, and because we've got handles, it's easier. If you don't have any handles, then you can glue it on. Now I'm threading my beads on, so you've made it a bit like shoelace, so it's easier. Now I'm tying a knot underneath so it doesn't fall down, and you're going to repeat that just with different beads. So now I'm tying my knot that will stop the beads from going down to the bottom at the end, so then they're nice and separated. Now I'm going to put a jingly bell on. Now I'm going to do
my last bead, and it's a flat bead. Well, not flat, but it's like a circle.
Now I'm gonna turn it to the other side,
tying a knot at the bottom, because we've gone round to the other side. Now I gotta do my pattern backwards. So now I'm gonna thread my last bead through instead of my first bead. Now I'm threading it down to my knot.
Now we're gonna repeat the steps to the top.
Now I've done all of my beads, I am now going to tie a knot up here and do a double knot to make sure it's secure.
So I've just literally just done all of the beads and bells, and now it's time for a bit of music.
So this is the bass drum, you know, the part where they put the foot on that part and then it bends this part. These are the side drums, and these are the cymbals! Now I'm going to play the drum with my different colour pencils. If you don't want this pencil sound, then you do it with your hands. I hope you enjoyed our festival drum tutorial. Make sure you like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye!